Gnar has been pretty popular lately. I wouldn't be surprised to see this locked in. And there it is. FlyQuest rounding out the composition with a Gnar.
Yeah, well, okay.
Will buy enough time for him to crash this wave, but there is a potential for diving this Gnar now, since Xerxes is still in the area, can pick up the crab, hit level 6, maybe go up there, since Gnar really would like to crash this. Look at how desperate he is trying to push this wave. It's a cannon wave as well. I'd love to see Revenge hold this. I hope you'd hit that.
Licorice going in there, looking for the all-in, looking for the solo kill on Revenge. He calls down the ulti, he places a barrel, the boy's at about no HP, and it's first blood for Licorice
now
in
coming
time.
Around, looking to potentially make a play, has the Onslaught of Shadows ready to go. Destiny's going in, the Lantern's been placed down, Johnson's just killed off before anything else can be done.
Xerxes Diotto is clearing top to bottom, and here he'll try to flash on Insanity.
Nice flash. Insanity could be in a bad spot here. Pulled back. Suppression comes through. Chaos Storm goes down. Say goodnight. Hand the kill over to
me. The timing of his camps is not available. So Xerxes up here doesn't get anything and frankly doesn't have anything else to do. He has the Rift Herald and Licorice is respecting that the heck across those areas a lot. Here's three men in the mid lane against Palafox with a flash.
Oh, they're making the move. They go in for the CC and they chain it beautifully. Palafox is down. Xerxes grabs
his completed first item, but neither does Palafox, who is about to die again.
Oh, Palafox getting hit with the Onslaught of Shadows and everything else in there. He falls over and Insanity takes the kill. Down here on the bottom side, it's Jose going in, looking for the kill, looking for the play onto Rays. But with the jump in from Destiny, who gets away, the Skarner ulti can't quite get it done. And that means Immortals walk their two players out of the bottom lane, but they will lose the tier one turn. Jose Diotto is here. Xerxes continues staying right on top of the Drake. We'll see if Jose wants to go in and coin flip this with a 50-50. Destiny trying to initiate here. Dragon's going to be taken by Immortals. Licorice getting himself away, but the damage is coming through. Xerxes grabbing the kill on Palafox as Johnson has to flash over the wall. True Shot Barrage coming in with Revenge with the flash follow. Looking to grab the kill, and he's got it. Parlay takes the kill on that one, but the Skarner ulti's got Gangplank's number. The oranges had already been used.
Engage up while the rest of FlyQuest is just now making it past the river. Okay, Licorice, you have no flash. You probably are dead.
Whoop. See you later, buddy. Destiny grabs a kill, just stabs him with the
lower. You've got the double QSSs now, and you're saying that Xerxes a good target. My man's paying taxes when he didn't even have to here. Let's see if Raze can get caught by Jose Diotto, who has flash.
Jose Diotto's going in. He found the one dude who doesn't have the QSS, and he pulled him in. Shut down over to Johnson. 2 minutes to go here, but Drake is spawning in about 30 seconds. Very nice pull coming out from Diamond, and Johnson is moving forward now. Raze eating a lot of damage. Johnson looking to finish him off here with a little bit more damage to grab the kill, but Revenge is able to take him down too. It's 80 carry for 80 carry, and for FlyQuest, it's getting a little bit scary here. Revenge continues to frontline, looking to find the damage onto Palafox. Another Lantern going to be thrown back, but another Lantern turn without any success. Crumbs, FlyQuest have already lost both of their big carries and their support is on the run. Immortals falling in here, chasing them down, and once again it's up to the horses to do the work. Xerxes coming in, needs a little bit more. A nice scatter of the week, and they'll give the kill over to Insanity. Immortals on a 9-5 game.
Do that to me again. So he pops it on the hook, and then when they commit, he buys so much time that then the Gangplank ends up showing up and just does so much on the back of that. And it actually ends up being a really big play because it was right before the Dragon. Fly was set up for the Dragon setup. They jumped the gun.
FlyQuest right now, based on the past few minutes of play, to go anywhere that's not already fully warded.
And they can have some.
I want a Silvermere Dawn poem out of
here. I got a poem for you. Roses are red, violets are blue. Camp my lane, or I'll int you.
Well, Diamond's about to find himself in a bad spot here. You don't have time for poetry or nothing else. Immortals grabbing a killing spree on him. Xerxes.
They need Aphelios to join this fight now. You gotta get this man an eye edge and then start fighting because you don't even have into that fighting. They take away Fly from the Baron. They get the Dragon, and now they can actually get a quicker reset. Need to get Johnson auto-attacking and dealing damage. Licorice doesn't have flash.
Okay, Immortals going for the play on Licorice, and they just destroy him before he's able to enter the mega form.
That means that Immortals are now looking for even more. Cersei jumping in with the devastating charge. A bad flash from Diamond way too late. Ends up just costing FlyQuest extra. Destiny may die here to the turret shot, and he will.
What?
Cersei's diving into the middle of three here with the Onslaught of Shadows. I don't know about that one. Ported back in. Drake is the focus coming out here from FlyQuest. Cersei's going and he steals away the Infernal Soul. This is a great fight for Immortals to take now. They've killed off the enemy AD carry. They've taken the Dragon Soul. Diamond's having to run away. Licorice goes for a kill, but he won't be able to find it just yet. Palafox at least takes down Destiny. He's chasing after Cersei looking for another, but he will not
get find this steal and get out is a giant win. But a raise, what?
Oh man, Palafox down to 100 HP. Revenge ends up grabbing a killing spree on him, but raise falls too. So we got a one for one here in this trade.
That probably is worth it for FlyQuest, being able to take down the AD, but Insanity has TP'd in here, and Johnson will be up to stop the inhibitor from going down, but not the turret, so IMT do get something for it, but they won't be able to go and
doing start that. Instead, Revenge will just be providing the side lane threat. Cersei trying to get away now as Raze might be in some trouble. Gets marked by the E, but gets over the wall in time before Jose is able to proc the stun. Raze continues to be the target here from the side of FlyQuest, but it will not work. Jose de Odo going to be tanking way too much here on the front line. Destiny doing the same. Revenge has not been able to join the fight here just yet, but now he's able to approach from the flank. Palafox going to be run down and cut down, and now they're continuing to chase even further. Palafox at least grabs a kill onto Destiny, but they've already lost two here on the side of FlyQuest to push even further forward. Johnson's on the run. Licorice nearly dead. Jose the same. And Immortals will go straight into the base looking for this mid lane in here.
I think they can end the game. The carry of Palafox is dead, and Aphelios does not have flash. If they can kill him, they can win right here, but there's also the potential for that Hail Mary Infernum and ultimate on Aphelios.
Oh, Jose de Odo went for it. He tried to get the ulti play, but the QSS was just too strong. Bottom lane inhibitor falls. It's a two-in-hip game now as Immortals will break the base of FlyQuest. Jose and Licorice and Johnson are trying to stand and fight, see if maybe they can catch somebody on a greedy recall. But Diamond and Palafox still dead for a little while longer. Palafox will have teleport when he respawns. They may look to make some sort of a pincer maneuver here with Palafox teleporting deep behind enemy lines. Will that teleport show up? Yes, it will. FlyQuest going in, still looking to take this fight, still looking to make some sort of a move. This could be their last-ditch chance to ever win a fight in this game. Palafox needs to find a little bit more damage. Nicely done from Insanity. Just zeroes him out and takes him down. Jose is on the front line, but it's a double kill for the Syndra. It's about to be even more. Raze takes the kill on Licorice. And with three dead on FlyQuest, Immortals are going right back where they came from, heading to the FlyQuest base. Diamond tries to get out. Oh no, man. Xerxe's in hot pursuit. Destiny's here too. He brings in Johnson and they're trying to fight against these guys. But once again, the horsing around combo. Eight legs is more than four. You don't win that 2v2, boys. Double kill back for Insanity. The Bud Light ace to wrap up the game. And Immortals are going to take down FlyQuest 39 minutes in.
That is a big momentum swing for IMT. 2-0 thus far, and they're slowly climbing up the ranks while pushing down the teams that are close to them. Now they're clearly above FlyQuest and slowly getting them.